Teacher Mogita Robert from KCI High School, a teacher of CRE. We want to have our first topic, Form 4. It's a Form 4 topic, but is also we are introducing it in Form 3 now that we cover the Form 3 syllabus. Form 4 work is deals with contemporary issues. It handles secular world issues. It is a paper 2. Form 4 is paper 2 topic. It's a form paper 2 topics in Form 4. And they are introduction to Christian ethics. We have response to sexual behavior. We have marriage. We have family. We have work. We have leisure. We have Christian approaches to issues related to money, wealth, and poverty. We have law, order, and justice, science, and technology. These are the topics in Form 4, and they assist the learner to answer the question 5 and 6 in the paper 2 CRE examination, national examination. This topic, Introduction to Christian Ethics, has only two objectives. We are supposed to know the meaning of Christian ethics. Secondly, we are supposed also to explain the sources or basis of Christian ethics. Where do we get Christian ethics from? What is the meaning of Christian ethics? And simply, the word ethics comes from a Greek word, ethikos, meaning conduct. How do you conduct yourself? That is ethics. It's a systematic study of human actions to determine their rightness or wrongness. How wrong, how right something is what we are calling ethics. We have now Christian ethics. Christian ethics is the study of human behavior from the Christian point of view. When you study human behavior from the Christian point of view, then you are dealing with Christian ethics. It's how Christians make choices in their daily life, guided by values and principles. How can someone or a Christian or anybody in the society acquire Christian ethics? Where do we get Christian ethics from? What is the basis? In a national exam, this question has been asked twice. 2012, question 5A was, explain the basis of Christian ethics, or explain the sources of Christian ethics. Where do we get Christian ethics from? The first place or the first source of Christian ethics is the Bible or the teachings of Jesus Christ. In the Bible, we are able to get guidance on morals to be followed. That's where we get the Ten Commandments, the teachers do not kill. So it is wrong to kill. So the Bible is a source of Christian ethics. We are not supposed to kill. We are supposed to preserve life. Two, traditions from a Christian community, stroke, or it's the same as church rituals, or authoritative Christian literature. You can read from the Christian literature or from the church leadership. The church leadership has the capacity to interpret and expound the will of God to Christians. The leaders in the church can expound on what is right. If you read also the Christian literature, we have books, a variety of books. For example, the SDA Church has a variety of books like The Desire of Ages and many other books that have been authored by Helen G. White. These books can also guide on what is right and what is wrong. The third, human reason or experience or conscience or faith in God, free will, intuition. For our own conscience, we are able to judge what is right, what is wrong from our human reasoning. We are endowed with human reason. And like animals which do not reason, human beings have intellect, have the conscience. The conscience will judge you. That's when sometimes somebody can tell you, let your conscience judge you. You know what you did, whether it was wrong or right. And four is natural law. This is the law of God, which is imprinted in the hearts of people. It means the awareness that one has to choose good and avoid evil. That is the natural law. The natural law has it that you are able to tell, you are aware that what you are doing is wrong naturally. You know that same-sex marriage is wrong. Naturally, a man is supposed to marry a woman. State laws or secular laws, we have the constitution, which is the supreme law of the land. So the constitution can also tell what is wrong or what is right. We have the institutional ethics or God's revelation. According to the situation that one finds himself in, one is able to take a course of action according to the situation. That can also assist one to acquire the moral values or the Christian ethics according to the circumstances you find yourself in. Lastly, we have African customs or culture or morality. From the our African cultures, different communities have a definition of what is good and what is wrong. You are able to know Africans are guided by taboos or customs in making their choices in their lives. Some Africans traditions conform to Christian teachings and they are right. And you cannot marry your sister. You cannot have a sexual relationship with your cousin. That is according, it's a taboo. And in the Christian context, the same morals are upheld. So from the African customs, we are able to know, we are able to acquire the Christian virtues. Another subtopic we have in this introduction, we have Christian values that create a just society. What are these values that can assist people in Kenya, for example, to have a fair society? In an exam situation, you can be asked to explain the different values or the different virtues that a Kenyan citizen needs to have for us to enjoy a fair society. And there are quite a number of them. We have love, we have honesty, we have fairness and justice, we have respect, faithfulness, we have humility, perseverance, and we have chastity. But in an exam situation, if you're asked to explain, then that means you are able to, you are supposed to explain each virtue. For example, if you say you have love, you can explain and say that if somebody has love, then you cannot kill your neighbor, you cannot steal from your neighbor. Hence, you are creating a just society by having love. If you are honest, then it means you can't have conflicts with others. You will also, you will always uphold what is supposed to be done in a society, and that will ease tension, or alternatively, it can also enhance good neighborhood and respect for other people's property. If you are, you respect other people's property, then it means you will not have conflicts with them. That will create a just society. If you are faithful, for example, in marriage, it means immoral practices will not be entertained. That will also create a fair society because you will not be conflicting with other people by having immoral behavior. If you are humble, you also respect other people's opinions. You persevere, and you are chaste. Chastity comes from the word chaste. That means you are pure. If you are pure in heart, it means you will be fair to other people. Then you, the society will be fair. We have life skills as a topic, and in life skills, we have different life skills. And one of it is, we handle this in Form 1 when we are dealing with Elijah, question 3, paper 1. Critical thinking is one of the life skills. These are abilities or potentials that one has to handle different situations. Critical thinking is a way of analyzing and making decisions and judgments to come up with new ways of doing things. You think critically, you analyze a situation and come up with new ways of doing things. That is why you don't do things the same way and expect different results. That is why you'll have to think critically as a life skill. Second, we have self-esteem. People, you either have a low self-esteem or a high self-esteem. It's a way we feel about ourselves. If you have a low self-esteem, sometimes you are unable to give your opinions in public. And if you are high self-esteem, then it means you are able to give your opinions even when other people have contrary opinions. Assertiveness ability to express your opinions and feelings openly. Some people are assertive. Let your yes be yes, let your no be no. We have decision making. It is it's making up one's mind in order to reach a solution, something in one's life. You want to decide on what you want to do in life. You make up your mind in order to reach a solution. Creative thinking is coming up with novel ideas on doing things, coming up with new ways of handling things. Then we have effective communication. Communication is very important. The issue of how do you communicate? You can have an idea, but how do you communicate so that other people can buy such ideas? So it is the art of mastering the language of interacting with others. We have steps in decision making. I've identified that life skill, now that is important. How do you decide on what to do? Remember, we're handling Christian ethics, explaining the meaning of Christian ethics and the importance of Christian ethics. At the same time, how do we acquire the sources of Christian ethics? But in between, how do you make a decision? It's a life skill that assists Christians to make decisions in life. We need to identify the challenge that we are facing. For example, as students, the challenge mostly we face, we have a challenge, how do I pass exams? That is a challenge. For example, you are failing in exams. Second, examine the situation by looking at the circumstances carefully so as to clearly understand the challenge. You have the challenge of not passing exams. And examine the situation. Why are you not passing? Maybe you're not reading. Maybe you're not working hard enough. You're not utilizing your time well. Find out all the possible options and alternatives. What are the options and alternatives available for you? Either you begin waking up early, you begin consulting other people in discussion groups. Come, utilize your time well. Find out all the possible options and alternatives that you have. Consider the possible cons for each option taken. For example, if you take an option of waking up early, maybe people will say you're trying to pretend, you also sacrifice your lunchtime. People think like you are trying to portray that you are reading. You can also consult teachers. People say you want to be seen by teachers. So consider the possible concept for each option you are taking. Select the option that is the best and put it into correct practice. That is to mean that even if people are saying you're consulting teachers because you want to be seen, you take it and put it into practice. Lastly, evaluate the outcome. Are you able to get the result from what you are able, the option you have taken? You've woken up early, you've started forming groups. Are you getting the result? Lastly, the last subtopic for our lesson today is what is the importance of life skills? You have life skills, what is the importance of it? One, helps people to live positively and happily. When you are assertive and you say your opinion, even when people are against it, you live positively and you are happy. Helps people to assess and avoid risky behavior in life. If you are able to say no, if you have a high self-esteem and you are able to say no to a risk situation, then that will make you avoid that risk situation because you've already said no. Helps people to make wise decisions in life because you've before you come up with a new idea, before you come up with a decision, you have gone through the stages that makes you to assist you make wise decisions in life. Helps people to build self-confidence in life. Life skills like being assertive, coming up with novel ideas, coming up with novel ideas as a life skill will make you to build up confidence in life. Another thing, it helps people to set goals and achieve them without problems. When you are making a decision, you are able to set your goals because part of decision making, it also assists to achieve those goals within the time frame you've set without problems. It contributes in making a happy and a just society. When you have these life skills, they will assist you. You say your mind, even if people are not happy with it, that you live happily. And you become fair to others. We've come to the end of our lesson. We basically were dealing with introduction to Christian ethics. We were explaining the meaning of Christian ethics, what ethics is, and the sources of Christian ethics, and we also captured the life skills because they are important in acquiring Christian ethics in life.